Yeah, well, this is the first proper germination of the Cariolochia creeper strain A, which is a hybrid of a Carioca, Bultiolochia, Trinidad Scorpion Moruga Red, and a Carolina Reaper or Reaper cross. There was one that germinated before, but this happened somewhere on the walls of this container. I can't see it right now here in this picture, but that was a bit weird. And you can see they got really long, the ones that have germinated, which is a clear sign of light deficiency. So let's rehouse them and give them some additional light, shall we? I'm using this terrarium as a makeshift mini greenhouse. I'll be needing one more of these coconut fiber thingies. You'll see why in a moment. Okay, I think it has soaked enough. Now let's get this wall germinator here. Pick it up carefully. This is it. And let's plant it properly this time. Whoops, sorry, I dropped you already when you were just a seed. Spray it down a bit. And watch them grow. Ah, the Achi Charapita are showing, finally. Only a few hours later in the evening they can be seen much more clearly. Okay, I think now's the time to rehouse them. I mean, ta-da!
The good. The bad. The ugly. Hey! The ugly.
The Cariolochia creeper strain A. This is the individual that germinated on the container wall. It has developed nicely. Sufficient roots on all of those, and this one has a slightly deformed leaf, hence the term ugly, but I'm seeing this as a good sign actually, because this is not unheard of in superhots. And this one is still clinging to its seed, kind of cute. Carolina Reaper Chocolate. Leaves also a bit deformed, maybe, and roots over here should be enough. Yeah, the chili from Tibet was a bit of a surprise. It has been a while since I grew actual pure annuums. I'm guessing this is an annuum variety, and you can see some of the leaves have a slightly purplish color, like the reaction they have to UV light, and I'm wondering if this will turn purple in sunlight. Interesting, it has already dropped one of the first leaves.
developed many roots, and it was the first to germinate and the biggest, as it would be expected for an annuum. We shall see. Yeah, and the Ahi Charapita germinated last, but it's coming along and looks quite okay. And I think I did plant 3 seeds and 3 plants, so germination rate 100%. That's okay. And I said Ahi Charapita in earlier video. I think it should be Ahi, just like jalapeno and Jesus. Maybe I will look that up. Anyway. Yeah, and many of my Cariolokia screeper strain A did not germinate at all in all this time. There's the seed. Nothing. I think this was because I had such clever ideas to pre-treat them before actual planting them in this little bag on a hot spot in a wet sponge cloth, but I guess this is the reason for this. But anyway, I only have to choose from 3 plants for my further breeding, so this is a bit of a plus. You know, sometimes it's not survival of the fittest or anything, it's just survival of the luckiest. 3 lucky plants, 3 is a good number.
Smallest odd prime, that is.
Carolina Reaper Chocolate in its new temporary home. The chili from Tibet, at least one of them. I have something special planned for the other plant. The Cariolokia Screepers strain A. Three of them. And the Ahi Charapita is still so small, it will stay in this container for a while. Witness my high-tech tripod in action. And now for some proper hydration. Huh, I can't reach this. This is better. I'm using this to increase the airflow. Yep, trying to go aquaponic with my chilies with this one. It is planted in rock wool and clay. And the roots go down in this aquarium. There are no fishes in there right now, but I have tried the system with a tree onion and some Japanese rice fish, and it worked so far. I will add a bit more water. I will leave this like this for a few days, and let's see. Looking good so far. Yeah, there are no fishes in there right now, but already snails, a few copepods, and some types of worms. And algae or cyanobacteria. So the system is biologically active, if you will. Oh, and my Cariolokia Scorpion strain D from last year is flowering like crazy. The Carolina Reaper or Reaper Hybrid, on the other hand, is already fruiting.
There are some fruits already on the plant, and new ones are apparently forming. So, things are looking up, I guess.